Are you ready to throw away your reading glasses after cataract surgery? Today, let's talk about some of the most common premium lenses and which one may be the best fit for you. Around middle age, all of us will develop presbyopia, which is a condition where you lose elasticity of the lens inside your eye. The lens acts like a focus, and loss of that flexibility results in progressive trouble with near vision. If you've never required glasses, you may find yourself struggling to focus at near and eventually depending on reading glasses. If you already wear prescription glasses, you may have had to add in a bifocal or progressive glass that accounts for this inflexibility. When the time comes for surgery, you may have the option to completely ditch glasses and get a type of premium lens that can correct for presbyopia. So what's the difference between a standard and a premium lens? A standard lens is a lens that's covered by insurance. This lens can focus at either distance or near, but not both. A premium lens is a lens that is not covered by insurance, and it can do things that standard lenses can't do, like correct astigmatism, or one step up from that is a multifocal or extended depth of focus lens, which can focus your eye at multiple focus points such as distance, computer, and reading. These type of lenses eliminate some or all your dependence on reading glasses, and in addition, all premium and EDOF lenses come with astigmatism correction if needed. Well, I do need to break some news. There is no perfect lens out there. You will never get your 20-year-old eyes back, and the only perfect lens is the one that you were born with. By selecting a standard versus a premium lens, you are going to have to make some compromises to achieve either best quality of vision at one focal point or a range of vision. Who should consider a presbyopia-correcting lens? If you absolutely hate wearing glasses for anything, this can be a great option for you. You will need to be okay with the fact that there will be a low level of glare and halos around lights at night. And there are also specific instances where I would not recommend this type of lens. For example, certain occupations like being a pilot or a long haul truck driver, where you really need to have good quality of vision for night driving or night flying, probably would not benefit from this lens. If your eye has other conditions such as early macular degeneration or a retinal scar tissue called an epiretinal membrane, or you may also not be the best candidate for this type of lens as well. As a cornea specialist, I usually don't like to offer presbyopia correcting lenses for patients with corneal irregularities or corneal diseases such as Fuchs corneal dystrophy. And personality can play a role here. If you are someone who is very detail oriented, you will be bothered by the low level of glare you'll have at night. In most of these cases, even though the prospect of having to wear glasses may not be the most appealing, it may actually be the best option for you. After all that, are you still considering a presbyopia correcting lens? Well, there are different types, then you will have to make a decision on what the best type is for you. There are two classes of presbyopia correcting lenses: multifocal lenses and extended depth of focus lenses. These lenses utilize different optical principles to provide a range of vision. Multifocal intraocular lenses are lenses that provide more than one focal point by splitting light into several focal points. For example, bifocal and trifocal lenses are both considered multifocal lenses. A bifocal lens has two focal points, usually distance and near, and a trifocal lens has three focal points, distance, intermediate, and near. Modern multifocal lenses are mostly trifocal lenses, which allow for excellent distance vision for driving, intermediate vision for desktop computers and dashboard, and near vision for reading. This eliminates the need for glasses altogether. The two multifocal lenses that I use most frequently are the Panoptics lens by Alcon and the Synergy lens by Johnson & Johnson. Both offer excellent distance, intermediate, and near vision, with the Panoptics lens just slightly edging out the Synergy lens for quality of distance vision, and the Synergy lens just edging out the Panoptics lens for quality of near vision. Both lenses do report a low level of nighttime glare and halos, which may be a valid reason for not considering this type of lens. With proper patient selection, this lens has an extremely high rate of patient satisfaction correction, but approximately 1 in 300 patients who receive these type of lenses require a removal or exchange due to intolerable symptoms. So it's really important that you really think about what your goals are and you talk to your surgeon before selecting this type of lens. Meanwhile, an extended depth of focus lens or EDOF lens has a longitudinally extended focal point by using optical properties with a continuous change of power from the center to the periphery of the lens. These lenses were designed to overcome the downsides of a multifocal lens, like issues with nighttime vision. And as a result, this lens typically has less halos and glare at night and does provide a good continuous range of vision with a very smooth transition from distance to intermediate. In order to achieve these results, you may not get the full range of vision that a multifocal would offer and may still require a light pair of reading glasses for fine print. The two most common EDOF lenses in the United States are Vivity by Alcon and Symphony by Johnson & Johnson. The Vivity lens is currently my EDOF lens of choice due to better quality nighttime vision compared to the Symphony lens, but there is a new version of the Symphony lens that just came out. I am really excited to try this lens and report back. So if you're debating between a multifocal lens or an EDOF lens, how do you know which one to get? Here are some considerations I would consider. If you have retinal pathology like macular degeneration or have been told that you have an epiretinal membrane, which is a type of scar tissue that grows on your retina, I probably would shy away from a multifocal lens and instead would do a EDOF or a monofocal lens. If you've been told that you have cornea diseases or you have an irregular cornea, you may want to consider an EDOF lens. Anyone with a history of LASIK refractive surgery or RK or radial keratotomy surgery, it's probably not the best idea to go forward with a multifocal lens. I love offering EDOF lenses for post-refractive eyes. If you're someone who needs good nighttime vision, I would probably stray away from any multifocal and perhaps even stray away from an EDOF lens. And if you are someone who just hates wearing glasses, even light readers, a multifocal lens is probably the way to go. Some eye surgeons will actually mix and match the different lenses. One popular option is using an EDOF lens on your dominant eye and putting a multifocal lens on your non-dominant eye. The thought here is that your dominant eye would have less glare and have maybe slightly better quality of vision, and your non-dominant eye would have a greater range in vision for near tasks. It's always a good idea to go into your cataract consultation with some idea of what kind of lens you'd like, but ultimately you should discuss your lens options with your eye doctors so they can guide you towards a lens that is the best fit for your needs. To leave your questions about cataracts and cataract surgery, feel free to subscribe so you don't miss out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.